Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to do another design tutorial. I'm going to show you how to create a very popular style on Etsy, and I call it the fruit festival design. I'm going to show you how to do it all for free using Canva. So let's go to Etsy first. I'll show you what this design looks like, and then I'm going to take you to Canva and how to lay it out and make it. All right, so I'm here on Etsy, on my Etsy page. I searched for a strawberry festival t-shirt. Now you can do any festival t-shirt, but I feel like the strawberry ones are the most popular. I did some filters here. I did over $10 to make sure that it's a t-shirt, not just a design. I got bestseller, and it's a physical item. This is a t-shirt. So take a look at these. This is the one I'm talking about right here. You can see strawberry festival. You see another one over here that's similar. They're both doing a lot of sales. Well, this one's doing more, 58 sales per month. This one's 10 sales per month, and it's only 2 months old. This one's 3 months old. Here's another one. This is 15 months old, probably the first one out there, 45 sales a month. Here's another one. They kind of look similar, right? This one right here and this one. I'm gonna teach you how to do one that looks like this, not exactly like this, but you can also switch out so you don't have to do strawberries. You can do other fruits. It can be blueberries, pineapples, mangoes. Like, you can scale this, and once you create one, you can switch out the graphics and switch out the words, of course, easily in Canva. And I'm gonna show you how to do it for free. So let's get into Canva right now and I'll show you how to do it. All right, so I'm here on Canva. You can see I've done a bunch of fruit stuff. I'm gonna just show you what I did here, just so you can get an example of how you can scale this. So here's my blueberry festival, my pomegranate festival, my pineapple festival, my raspberry festival, my peaches festival, and you can switch out, you know, make it work on a dark color like we saw on the example. So you can do two, you can do easily just change the colors and do it on a dark color shirt and a light color shirt. Here's strawberry on a light color shirt, here's strawberry on a dark color shirt, and so on. So I could have done more than this, but just so you can see that this is scalable. There's all these right here that you can use, all in Canva, all this artwork's in Canva, and they have some really good fonts too. So I'm gonna start from scratch, just so you can see how to do it. So create, go to create right here in Canva. I'm gonna take custom size, 4,500 by 5,400. You can type that in if it's not a recent one. For me, it's recent, but use pixels right here, and you can do that, perfect. And it's gonna have your artboard right here. Now, one of the ways that I like doing this, you can search here in templates. Sometimes you might get lucky. I'm gonna do fruit festival and shirt right here. Now, this is just shirt, showing you all the templates. If anybody made one, it would be in here. I don't see any, but you can get some good fonts and some good things from doing it like this. There's a strawberry one and so on. The other way I would check, and the way that I did it, was just to go to elements, and we're just gonna type in this case, strawberries. In fact, I'll just do strawberry, and then I'll do line art, like that. And you can see there's a bunch in graphics, so I'm just gonna hit see all. Now, if you're doing this for free, you're gonna have to use one of the free ones, and luckily, look how many strawberry ones there are here. This one right here is for free. You can see that. These are paid, this one. I actually think this one's nicer. I like having the one that has a sliced in half, and there may be one that's sliced in half for free, but I'm just gonna pick the free one just so you can see we can build this for free. So here's the free version right there. Next thing you're gonna wanna do is find leaves. So I'm gonna do leaf and then wreath. That's what we wanna do. Leaf wreath or leaves wreath, one of those things would work. Hit enter, and look at this. So many of them out here, and a bunch of them for free. Again, I would do like a black and white one. Like, this one's really cool, but that one wasn't for free. Let's make sure that we have the free one here. This one's free, that was a cool one. I like having the leaves kind of hollow to match the style of this one right here. So let me see if I can find one. Yeah, this one's really cool. This one was for free. I could do magic recommendations as well and look at some other ones for free. Now, if you see that it's connected like this, one thing that you can do that really helps is this crop. So I'm gonna crop it, and I'm gonna crop it halfway like this. And this is so that we can be more flexible. I'm gonna click outside of it. I'm gonna get rid of this one. And now I can use this and turn it, you see that? And just have it on this side. And if I want it on this side, I can copy it. Now there's a bunch of other ones here. This one's really cool too, another free one. So you can switch these out. Like if you're using this one for the strawberry, maybe you wanna use this one for your other fruit and this one for another fruit. Like look how cool some of these are. And they're all free again. So you can do this for free. Next thing you're gonna wanna do is to have some text. So we're just gonna go to text and we're gonna add heading. Now, if you don't know what fonts to use, you can always come down here and look at these. Like there's some fonts here that you could use that are paired very nicely because they already paired them. Like this one right here, join the celebration. I'm gonna make this bigger. You could separate these, right click on here, do ungroup here. I would make sure to take off the effects though. So I take this off and make it that and make sure to take that effect off as well. And we don't need the curve on that one. We could use the curve on this one. So I'm gonna do that for now just to make it easy. I'm gonna do strawberry for strawberry festival. And I'm just gonna make it bigger like that and boom. And then we got this guy here. Now this one could be festival. Boom. And this could be bigger. You can see we're really close now. And then the bottom, I would just use the same font that's on the top. So come up with some kind of funny pun or whatever. I think those work. I'm gonna do a very good time. Now this one's gonna be smaller like this. And it's gonna have to arch the other way. So come back into your effects, arch it this way. There you go. Look at that. Now a lot of them I see put the date, some random date to just make it look like the festival was from the 70s. So I'm gonna do this again, but I'm gonna take off the effects, not have the curve, and then do like 19. I've seen that. And I'll make this smaller here. And maybe put 19 up here somewhere. And then you got like 73 or whatever. And then, oh, we gotta make sure that this is on this side and then I can just flip it. Boom. And of course, we're gonna turn it a little bit. So come in here, now it's time to kind of play around with like spacing. So do we want this bigger here? Do we want the fruits bigger? Yeah, I think so. Maybe this doesn't fit on the side. Let's move to 1973. And make sure we got the main, let's do the main elements first. Right? Looks like there's space right here. And so what I'm gonna do is instead of doing side to side, I'm just gonna do 1973 or whatever year you wanna pick, just on the side here and maybe, see that? I'm filling in that space, like this white space right here. See, and I could even turn this one and make it kind of a diagonal thing just to give it some, there, right? Just to give it just a little bit more fun at a diagonal. I like to do some things like that, just some interest, give it some interest here. Now what you wanna do is color it all the same color. So in this case, I'll probably color it the same color as the strawberries here. And since the strawberries already have color, it's right there. So that's more of a vivid brown. Maybe we want a red. Let's color the strawberries first. I'm gonna come in here and then, oh, it's kind of a red. Let's do more. Yeah, it wasn't that brown. It was more just dark red. Okay. And then let's do this the same color. Boom, now that we have it all the same color. You know, let's see. I like having the one color because it makes it just look more vintage. This is what we used to do back in the day when we silk screened stuff. You know, keep it one color, so keep the cost down. That kind of gives it the more vintage festival look, is keeping it one color. And lastly here. Now, you don't have to use these. I'm gonna show you some other fonts that you can use instead of these two. I'm gonna make a duplicate here and just change out the fonts just so you can see it. So one way I would do it is to come in here and first I would type in like a condensed serif. And the reason for condensed is because strawberry is a long word, we want it in here. So check out some of these fonts here. This one's not as condensed as the other one, but that's a nice one. DM serif, look at some of, you want some of these. Oh, this one's really condensed, that's really fun. Rockwell, yeah, that's kind of cool. Bauer, you know, it has that vintage feel. I really like this one. It's called Farmland Serif. Look at that. That looks really cool. So that's a good one that you can use. I would also type in farm, since this is a farm thing. And you can see Farmer's Market. I don't know, that's kind of fun. Farmer's Sands, Farmland Sands. Farmhand Sands, I gotta read that better. And Farmhand Serif, those are both pretty fun ones to use. And then as far as script fonts here, you can come in here and just type in script. So I'm gonna go in here and type in cursive or script. Let's try script first. You can see some of these right here. Cursive is another one, you can see right here. Feeling passionate, that's kind of cool. Apricots is a nice one. And again, a lot of these are free. Look at all the free fonts that you got right here. This one's really cool. I like this one. It might have to be down. This one is called Miss Truly. So depending on the font you have, you may have to like change it up a little bit. So let's do the farm on this one. What do we see? I'll just type in farm again. And it was Farm Sands. Very good time. Okay, so the way to change the color on this one, let's say this is the one that we want to use on the dark t-shirt, on the red pink t-shirt. I'm going to change the color of the background here to something dark first, like this. And then I'm going to change these to white. So I can come in here, change it to white. Boom. Even this one right here, it changed to white. Change this to white. Boom. One, two more. White and white. There you go. And then this now can be the color of the shirt that we want, maybe that red shirt. Isn't that cool? Now, next thing you want to do if you want to scale this is to duplicate this again, duplicate page, keep all of it on, and then maybe change this to blueberry. So then now I come in here and I look for blueberries. You use the same thing, line art, like this. And here's a bunch of them and a bunch of free ones. Look at this free one. You can come in here, make this, you know, white again. I just picked the first one. You can use whatever, and it fits nicely in there. In fact, I can make this 1973 maybe a little bigger. Yeah, that's fun. And maybe change it to, I didn't change this font to the sand. Yeah, there you go, the Farm Sands. And of course, it's not strawberry anymore. It's a blueberry, right? Boom, and it could be bigger now. Or one thing that you could do is the line spacing. We have this. We can do the letter spacing. Blueberry Festival. Isn't that easy? Isn't that cool? That's so nice there. And oh, again, we can change this out if we wanna do another one. We can do leaf wreath, right? That's what we said. All right, looking for some free ones. That one's kind of a cool one. Where was the other one that we found? We scrolled down here a little bit before we found it. Oh, this one's a nice one. Let's see if there's any others. Yeah, so there's so many cool ones in here. Oh, this one was cool too. So I could switch this out, you know, and put this in instead. And now we got a whole different one. We can just flip it And now we got a different look here. I'm gonna color it white. And that's how easy it is to go from strawberry to blueberry. Of course, you can change the tagline here. And you can do this over and over again, like I did with the pineapple and the mango and the like. Ask ChatGPT how many fruits there are, and you can probably make 20, 30 of these with different fruits. And that's how easy it is. If you wanna like eyeball this, boom, okay. Oh, of course, this wouldn't be on a red t-shirt. It's gonna be more on a like a blue t-shirt like that for blueberry, right? All right, let me show you how to export these. It's real simple. Hit share, hit download. Now, if you don't have the pro version, you're gonna have to remove the background in somewhere else. And that could be easy, especially if it's just white, you just remove the white background. But if you do have the pro version, that's one nice thing. You can hit transparent background. And I'm gonna download all of these PNGs, hit download, and they'll be ready to go. So there you go, real easy to do. Again, I would come in here. If you don't have the remove background, I would make this black actually. And then it's really easy to remove just the black or just the white in this case. So in this case, when you download this one, just remove the white. In this case, when you remove this one, just remove the black. And what you're left it with is the white right here. And then you can use this on where you wanna sell your t-shirts. Pretty cool, right? All of this is free. The only thing that's may not be free, or not, you can't do on here is that remove the background. All right, before I leave, I wanted to show you that you can actually do this for free. Here's Photopea. If you don't have Canva Pro and you have the background and you made it black or white, I'm gonna show you how to remove it. So here you go. I'm gonna pull in the black one here. There it is, Strawberry Festival. Remember I said to turn it black. This is gonna be real easy to remove here because it's just two colors. So Photopea can do this really well. I'm gonna hit select. I'm gonna hit color range right here. And it's gonna show you like the fuzziness. You can pull this all the way back or you can pull this all the way this way, 200. And it's selecting the sampled color, which is black already. So by default, black is the sampled color. I'm gonna hit okay. You can see the dotted lines here. All I need to do is hit backspace or delete on your keyboard. And there you go. It removed it right there. Now I'm gonna pick the background. I'm gonna hit option D and it removes the dotted lines here. And then all I have to do is go file, export as PNG, boom. And then I'm gonna do 4,500 by 5,400, that's what it is. And this, I'm gonna just call it whatever. So this one's the Strawberry Festival. And then hit save. There you go. All knocked out, this gray means that it's knocked out. You can put it on your Printify, if you're selling on Etsy, or if you're selling on Amazon or whatever, it's ready to go. It's PNG, transparent background, the right size, and everything. Good to go, no background. Really easy and free. So there you go, that's how easy it is to create these for free using Canva. There's lots of line art for fruit, so you can scale these. You can see that these sold a lot on Etsy, but I've already sold a bunch of these on Amazon as well. So hopefully this is really helpful to help you get some sales this Q4. Now, if you wanna see some other designs in Canva or some other fruit ones, I'll show you how to do this one right here in Canva. This is another version of that fruit stand. Fruit style design. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.